Hello and welcome to Honey Beach Orchids. Today we are going to take some samples from the purebred queens to test the Varroa mites that are currently on the bees. It's one of the three ways we test the infestation of Varroa mites. The first is in March when the willow blooms. We check the natural fall, the natural deaths of the mites at the bottom of the hive. During summer we test with the pin test with a very small needle we push some cells in, or we put little holes in the cell, and the bees we measure how much of those cells the bees clean out. It's one of the important things for detecting Varroa and then cleaning it out. And if they clean it out, the Varroa still lives, but they can't breathe outside a kept brood cell. So if the bees have that behavior, it's very positive. And we have the test we do today is the bees that are on the mites at the end of the season. Of the mites that are on the bees. The mites are very big. If it was to compare to a mite that would live on us humans, it would be the size of a soup dish. So that would be that's quite a big parasite for a bee. That's what I'm going to show today. Well, what do we need for that? Our smoker. Our hive tool, a little pee cup from the hospital where they test your pee in, a clean one of course. This probably approximately holds about 30 grams, a bit more, a bit less of bees. Our cool box, and the bucket to shake some bees in. The cool box is because bees are cold blooded. If I put bees in here and I put the lid on and I leave them, they will die a horrible, horrible death. If I close the lid and put it in a cold cool box or immediately in the freezer, they are cold-blooded, so they fall in a slumbering sleep and die without them even knowing it. They go into a sort of a coma because of the cold. That's the most and the only humane way to take a humane sample from the bees. There are 30 bees are coming in it of 330 grams, about 300 bees. So the hive, it doesn't matter for the hive, but we gotta do it humane. It's the only right thing to do. So let's get on with it. Those 300 bees, they die now, but they will be it's for the greater good. In following years, those 300 bees can be a part of this the savior of maybe millions of bees. So it's for the greater good. Sorry about the noise. They're working out here, and people work, so who works gotta work. If you liked it so far, please give a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. I would really appreciate it. So I'll take off the inner covers. Give a good tap. Oh, look who's walking here. Can you see that? I guess not. You don't see that a lot. There she is, the queen. It's a good thing we know that we don't have the queen come and pick her up. There she is. We put her in there, back in her home. And we'll take a frame from here. So we know the queen is not here. That's a good thing. There she goes, back into the hive. Well, that was a bit of a surprise. But okay, it's all in good fun. The bees don't always do what you think the bees will do. There were not many bees on it, so I'm gonna take another frame. At the opposite side of where the queen went back in, they can be fast, but they can't be that fast. Hey, I got a sting. I thought I feel something nibbling. It's still quite humid. These are no fans of that, but. So that's enough. Give it a shake. Now I'm going this one-handed again. Let's see if it works. Close it up. Straight in the cooling box. They will fall asleep very, very, very soon. Just in a minute or so, maybe even less. Those remaining bees can go back. There they go. And that's part one of testing a honeybee colony. The rest happens at home. And see you for the next part at home. Thank you.